Good morning, children. Hope you are all doing good. Welcome back to science class. Shall we begin our class? Okay. What is compound? A compound is a pure substance which is formed when two or more elements combine chemically in definite proportion. Let me repeat it. A compound is a pure substance that is formed when atoms of two or more elements combine chemically in definite proportion. Let's take water as an example. Water is a compound made up of two elements, namely hydrogen and oxygen. These two elements combine chemically in a ratio of 2:1, which means two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. In this proportion, they combine together and form a compound called water. So water is an example of compound. I use water to explain what is compound. So again, I repeat the definition. A compound is a pure substance that is formed when the atoms of two or more elements chemically combine in a fixed proportion. Next, we are going to see some examples of compounds. The common salt we use in our day-to-day life is an example of compound. Common salt is a combination of two elements, namely sodium and chlorine. Sodium and chlorine combine in a ratio of 1:1 and they form a compound called sodium chloride. Sodium chloride is a substance we use in our day-to-day life. Let's see some more examples of compounds and the elements present in it. The first example I take is chalk. Chalk is a combination of three elements, namely calcium, carbon, and oxygen. One atom of calcium, one atom of carbon, and three atoms of oxygen. All these three elements combine chemically and forms a compound called chalk, calcium carbonate. The next example is sugar. Sugar is a compound made up of combination of again three elements, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. 12 atoms of carbon, 22 atoms of hydrogen, and 11 atoms of oxygen combines and forms a compound called sugar. The next example I take is baking soda. This also we used in our day-to-day life. Baking soda is a combination of four elements. The elements are sodium, hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen. One atom of sodium, one atom of hydrogen, one atom of carbon, and three atoms of oxygen combines and gives us baking soda, which is a compound. The next example I take is ammonia. Ammonia is a compound in which nitrogen and hydrogen combines in the ratio of 1:3. One atom of nitrogen and three atom of hydrogen combines and forms a compound called ammonia. These are few compounds which we use in our daily life. Compound has some properties. Compound exhibits some properties. Let's see few properties one by one. The first property of compound is a compound is formed only when the constituent elements combine in a fixed proportion. What are constituent elements? The element which makes up the compound are called constituent element. Here, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of hydrogen. So we took two elements. The elements are hydrogen and oxygen. These two elements combine in a fixed proportion. What is the proportion? 2:1. Two atom of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combines and forms a compound called, can you guess? Yes, the compound is water. So wherever we take water, whether it from a lake, ocean, or wherever, the proportion is 2:1. The next property of compound is the properties of compound entirely different from those of its constituent elements. For example, again I take water as an example. Water is liquid in room temperature. Okay, and the constituent elements that makes up water, those elements are gases in room temperature. See, it says the properties of compounds are different from those of its constituent elements. The constituent elements are gases, but the compound they make is liquid in room temperature. Can you see the difference in the properties? And one more difference among them is water helps in switching off fire. Water can be used as a fire extinguisher. We use water to put off fire. But one of the constituent element that makes water, that is oxygen. Oxygen is a good supporter for burning. See the difference between the compound and the constituent elements. That's what the property says. The property says the property of a compound are different from those of its constituent elements. I hope you understood. Yes? Okay. Let's see another property of compound. Do you understand the differences between the property of a compound and the property of the constituent elements? They are entirely different. They are not same. Okay, the next property of a compound is the constituent elements of a compound cannot be separated using physical methods. You all would have learned in your 6th standard some separation techniques like hand picking, filtration, magnetic separation, all these are physical methods. Yes? Can we use these physical methods to separate the constituent elements from a compound? Okay, let me ask in this way. Water is made up of two elements. They are hydrogen and oxygen. Do you think, can we separate these hydrogen and oxygen from water using hand-picking method? No, it is not possible, right? Can we separate the hydrogen and oxygen atoms from water using filtration method? No, it is also not possible. Can we separate the hydrogen and oxygen atoms from water using a magnet? No, which is also not possible. So the physical methods are not possible to separate the constituent elements from a compound. Then, if we want to separate the constituent elements, how it is possible? In what way we can separate the constituent elements from a compound? Okay, we have separation methods to separate the constituents from a compound. That's the fourth property. The fourth property says compound can be broken down into its constituent elements only by chemical methods. Only by chemical methods. What is that chemical method? There is a method called electrolysis. Electrolysis is a method which uses electric current. The electric current decomposes the constituent elements. Decompose means splits the constituent elements from the compound. So this is the only chemical way to split the constituent elements from a compound. Physical methods cannot be used to separate constituent elements from a compound. Only chemical methods are used. Let's see some differences between elements and compounds. The first difference is elements. Elements is the simplest substance, but compound is a chemical substance formed by combination of two or more atoms. Elements combine to form compounds. Compounds can be split into elements. Atoms are the fundamental particles of an element, because only when atom combines, an element formed. But molecules are the fundamental particles of a compound. When molecule combines, they form compound. So these are some basic differences between elements and compounds. Hope you understood up to this, children. That's all about today's class, children. I'll meet you in the next class. Bye. Take care.